and get out of the kingdom. Jay, I want to compliment you. You know, when you got around to your boy, think about meeting them boys across the line in heaven, you brought a smile to that man's face. You know, that's a hard thing to do sometimes. He was grinning over there, and that's good. If you decide not to go to Georgia Tech, that other school, Auburn, would be a good place for you to play. I want to talk just a second. My name is Jimmy Watley. Been on Jerry Jones, and I do have two kids that have graduated. I had the pleasure of serving 6 years, sitting by Mr. Lee there. He would elbow me and tell me to be quiet, but I enjoyed it, and I take my hats off to all of y'all. It's a tremendous service that you provide to our children and to our city.
Amen.
It is it's phenomenal. Ms. Brown, you did an outstanding job. I saw some phenomenal improvement. I like to see the direction the ball is moving. When my children graduated, I'd look at the ninth grade numbers, and that'd be 850 or 900. And then they'd graduate with 350 was winning. And so we're losing some somewhere. I serve in one of the ministries called Pirates. We go into the prison. I'm not a member of QE. I haven't been to one of the meetings nor given a penny. But I have participated in trying to help with the plan. You said you read twice. And that prison, the two things that's characteristic of most of those young men right here in the big house is they have no parent, no father figure at home. And the second one is basically no education. They've fallen out. And so I wonder if we could hear an evaluation from you of what the new system would be. Because my simple math shows we're losing a large number of young people between the 9th and 12th. And you've been quoted as saying it was 53%. So you've been quoted. I didn't hear you.
I was misquoted, and I'm going to clear that up right now.
Sure.
Right. Because I'm tired of it being misquoted. And I'm offended by it. The data that he's talking about is when we had our first open forum, there were very many questions that were asked of our school district that were very complex questions, but they were asked as though they were simple questions to answer. And one of those talked about the new graduation rate. And I was very familiar with the new graduation rate, and I was also familiar that in 2009, there were some attempts by an organization called Achieve, which is out of Washington, D.C. It's a think tank that's looking at graduation. It's looking at the number of students across our nation that are dropping out. And Achieve was one of the organizations that really helped to drive the state and the nation come to one uniform measure to calculate graduation rate, because everybody does it differently. And in 2009, Achieve looked at Georgia data, and they attempted to look at what those projected numbers would be if we were calculating on this new rate. And they projected that Valdosta City Schools' rate would be 53%. But that wasn't necessarily looking at it the way it's going to be calculated now. Because what they did is they looked at our ninth grade enrollment. And in 2009, our ninth grade enrollment was 698 students. Now, I know you said that you thought we had 850 kids as freshmen. Our enrollment in our school district this year was 7,700 students, 7,700 students spread across pre-K to 12th grade. We have not had a class of 898 kids ever in the Valdosta City Schools, because we can't, this is our largest enrollment we've had in 10 years. When that data was calculated or projected in 2009, they used our freshman class, which was 698, which was not our real cohort class rate. That included freshmen that had not obtained enough credits to move on. And anybody that knows anything about data in the nation and about high schools, you'll hear them talk about the freshman class as fresh wars, because we have high enrollment in ninth grade because we have a lot of kids across our nation that have come to school not prepared, not invested, or not motivated. And and that's when kids drop out. And so part of what's propelled this national momentum is to address that issue. In that year in 2009, when they reported our 4-year projected rate, it was based on 698 kids that included real ninth graders, but also kids that really weren't ninth graders but were reported as ninth graders because they hadn't moved on. Our real graduation, our real cohort rate was about 200 kids less. So it doesn't make the math work. That rate, and I've asked multiple times at people at the state level what our numbers are. They say it is impossible to release those numbers because at the time when those projections were made, the rate and the formula had not been determined completely. They were just doing projections. So it's impossible to say until that data is released in December 1st. So I think what we need to do is look at the data we have because we know that's the accurate data. And then we can think about and we can make some ideas, but we really don't know. And it puts a false message into our community about what we as a school district are doing when we make projections on things that we don't know about. And when we misinterpret information that we're sharing. And so again, I stand by what our graduation rate is as it's reported today. And December 1st, we will have that new graduation rate, and we will start working and addressing and doing the work that we can to address our students that aren't graduating in 4 years. But we are doing enormous things within our district to meet the needs of kids. We have so many students that don't graduate in 4 years, but are still enrolled in our alternative school. They're coming back to our high school to take coursework. They're doing credit recovery. We're doing all of these things to try to graduate students for our community. And to constantly say that we're only graduating 50% of our kids is